Hello, in this video, we will look at the cellular network. Cellular technology was developed by Bell Systems in the late 1940s, partially due to advancement made in the two-way radio during the Second World War. It would take a few more decades before the first generation of the cellular network appeared in the late 1970s. Now half a century later, we are witnessing the fifth generation of the network, which is poised to disrupt not just the mobile sector, but technology as a whole. But if we are going to look at the cellular network, we need to do it on two fronts: the network itself and the wireless signals it uses. The world is now more connected, and there are becoming fewer and fewer places where there isn't some form of cellular coverage. To provide this coverage to a geographical location, a cellular network is divided into what are known as cells. To deliver the best coverage with a limited number of dead spots, a cell usually takes the shape of the hexagon, in contrast to the square and the circle. Each cell is manned by a cell tower, which provides service for mobile devices in that area. A cellular network is not all wireless. In fact, other than the connection between cell towers and mobile devices, the remainder of the network is usually linked through landlines. These lines, which are often fiber optic cables, can span cities and even continents. Here's a general makeup of a cellular network. A cell tower is connected to what is called a mobile switching center. These centers, which are linked to the cell backbone and the internet, can keep track of mobile devices through their SIM cards. When making a call, your device will send a request to the local mobile switching center, which will then locate the device you are calling and make the connection. And that's just the basic rundown of the cellular network. Let's now move on to the wireless signals. It will be quite difficult for phones or any form of communication device to be mobile without the use of wireless signals. These signals are modulated so that information can be sent between the device and the cell tower. Throughout its existence, the cellular network has relied on wireless frequencies that ranged anywhere from hundreds all the way up to billions of hertz. As expected, the higher the frequency of a signal, the greater its bandwidth. But this boost in capacity does come with a downside of a diminished reach, which means an increase in cell towers, a hurdle that will have to be overcome by the next generation of mobile networks. When making a call, an open channel is given to your device. This channel is a subset of a range of frequencies allocated to the tower the device is connecting to. Because cell frequencies are usually confined to an area, they can be used by multiple cells, which makes for more efficient use. But this form of wireless recycling has to be done with moderation, because sharing the same range of frequencies among nearby cells will lead to signal interference. Other than frequency reuse, a cell tower, with the exception of those from the first generation, can hand connections off to another tower without service interruptions, which provides users with an even greater range of mobility. So there you have it. The cellular network consists of interconnecting cell towers which use modulated wireless signals to connect mobile devices. I know this was just a general breakdown of the cellular network, and I hope to dive deeper into the topic in future videos. So did this video provide any of the answers you were seeking? Let me know in the comments down below. And if you liked the video, please give it a like and consider subscribing if you're not. Thank you for watching and see you in the next one.